All right, so I'm gonna explain why they're getting death wobble in the JL. So I have another longer video that you can watch. It's almost 20 minutes. It explains resonance and harmonic motion. You're gonna have to understand both of those to really understand what's going on with the JL, but this will just be a quick little explanation. I remember the first time I did a lift on a JL and the first time I even really saw a JL. I was like, man, and this, don't get any of my words twisted. I love the JL. It's a great suspension. It's a very nice Jeep. But I remember looking over the steering and the track bar and I thought, man, that's some beef. That stuff, like, it's big. It's awesome. It's looking good. And I was building it for SEMA, so we were ripping all that stuff off and putting some aftermarket stuff on there. And I remember I pulled off the track bar and I was like, dude, this thing's big around. It was light, though. It just didn't weigh nothing. And I was like, man, that's interesting. And the steering, once I got that off, I'm like, dude, this stuff is really light. So I took a track bar and I cut it in half. And I was looking at the inside and like, man, that's some pretty thin steel. I did the same with the drag link and cut it in half. And like, man, it's just thin. And you start playing with it and watching what's going on, it's acting like a tuning fork. Now, all metal is susceptible to resonance. Pretty much everything is, glasses, and what resonance is a vibration going through it. If you watch the intro and outro to my videos, that's a bone stock JL Sport, not lifted, no big mud tires, nothing like that, with just terrible death wobble. Now, obviously, there's two or three different dampers that FCA's came out with. There is, they had steering gear issues, they had some reflashes, there's all kinds of stuff. But what I'm talking to you is the guy that's been to a dealer 7 times. They've done everything and it still has death wobble. The reason is because the window for resonance to come into that system is way too big. It's because of what they built the steering and the track bar out of. The vehicle doesn't have, I mean, it's run low caster, but the reason is so it turns nice and sharp. It gives you a nice driving feel, but they're relying way, way too heavily on a strong stabilizer to knock down all that resonance. What it is the vibration coming in. They're using that insurance policy, and that window is way, way too big. You are gonna keep having problems with it. That's the long and short of it. They'll redesign some stuff. They'll do some other stuff. I mean, obviously they had ball joints that were loose. They had track bar brackets, all kinds of stuff. But the fundamental issue is right here. You're gonna see that right in the steering and the track bar. I'm not saying to go rip it off and throw the heaviest thing you can get your hands on, but what I'm saying is replace it and put the best tested stuff out. The stuff that was engineered to fix it, not one-ton Chevy tie rod ends or something that was never really designed for that Jeep. They just kind of band-aid it together to go on it. And because I'm not saying bigger, heavier is always better. I want to see stuff that's tested. I want to see stuff that was proved to narrow that window of resonance to come. All right, so if you put a stronger stabilizer on or something like that and it took care of your death wobble, great. But as long as you understand, you just put a stronger band-aid on. That's all you did. This system is way, way too open to resonance. The window is just way too big. We gotta narrow that down. And a lot of this is gonna be right down there in the components themselves. And I've been kind of frustrated because it's been funny to watch, like all these people, and I feel bad for them. They've spent so much money on these Jeeps and they're going to a dealer 8 or 9 times. The dealer's hands are tied. They're only doing what they're told, but nobody's standing back and actually saying what's really going on. What's really going on is drag link, tie rod, track bar, they're acting like a tuning fork. And there's just, that window is way, way too open for resonance. That's just, we gotta tighten that thing up. Now, just like a tuning fork, I could make a tuning fork out of all kinds of different metals. To get that thing to resonate and to move is gonna take different forces. There's metal we can make it out of that's much easier. There's metal we can make out of that's much harder. The metal and the way that these are designed, it's super easy. And that's why it's a fundamental issue. We can put a strong stabilizer on it to try knocking down that vibration, knocking down that resonance. But it's a fundamental issue. And I don't see the stabilizer being the answer because we all know how that works. We know that we shouldn't be doing that. Let's put some good stuff on it and be done with it. And I hate to tell you that. I feel really bad if you've spent a lot of money and you're still frustrated because your Jeep's death wobbling, and it just sucks. But like I say, I love the JL. It's a great Jeep. I plan on buying one. It's just that's the issue. Like, everybody's kind of beating around the bush. That's the issue, is the darn drag link tie rod and track bar tuning forks. It's just not gonna work.